surprisingly, Nearest Neighbor, despite being the oldest machine learning algorithm out there, is still going pretty strong in a lot of applications.
This is Misha Bilenko, a researcher at Yandex, who visited EPFL a few weeks ago.
While in research, there is definitely a dominance of interesting work on neural nets right now, in production, pretty much all the retrieval and matching systems that you see, they rely on Nearest Neighbor very heavily.
To make some predictions for some features X, Nearest Neighbor consists of determining the nearest neighbor X prime of X that has been observed. Calling Y prime the label of features X prime, Nearest Neighbor then predicts Y prime as the label of features X. Now, this sounds basic, almost too basic. Can it really work better than neural networks?
So the major advantage that I think is not discussed enough is the ability of Nearest Neighbor to incorporate model changes very quickly. So as soon as you have examples or errors and examples that correct them, or newly labeled examples, with most other models, taking them into account is pretty tricky. You need to retrain the model. As opposed to Nearest Neighbor, where you simply need to add the examples to the corpus, make sure that the indexing happens, and then your model will be giving correct predictions for those examples. And so this ability to react very quickly by simply incorporating more examples is a very nice unique property of Nearest Neighbor that is very useful for operational systems, where sometimes you do want to have this ability to react to users' complaints or to bad errors that you found quickly without retraining all the models.
Now, it should be said that nowadays, Nearest Neighbor is usually combined with some other machine learning techniques.
The original data representation is very often not ideal for doing Nearest Neighbor lookups. Sometimes it's not expressive enough, sometimes it's too high dimensional. So nowadays, the representations in which the Nearest Neighbor search happens are heavily transformed. The transformations sometimes increasingly are done using neural networks because they allow learning highly nonlinear, very complex transformations that really correspond to the true measure of similarity that is optimal for the dataset. But they can be all kinds of encodings and transformations. In the end, the most common pattern that happens is that you want a relatively low dimensional representation on which you can do Nearest Neighbor, unlike the original data that is now increasingly high dimensional.
So what are the challenges left in Nearest Neighbor research?
So one of the challenges is that the fact that it's so effective and now is being incorporated for this property of fast response, fast model change, given that it's at the same time, it's still not as powerful as parametric techniques in terms of the overall error function. And so what is being done often is the combinations of Nearest Neighbor with other parametric methods such as neural nets or boosted trees. Finding more principled ways to do such combinations is definitely an open research challenge. That would be quite interesting. And of course, more ways to do metric learning effectively and in highly efficient ways always will be a kind of key way to keep Nearest Neighbor as accurate as possible.
We don't understand what these neural networks actually do and why they work well, and if we can make any theoretical statements about it.
Well, Tay was a bot that Microsoft launched in 2016, I believe, on Twitter, that was a chit-chat bot.